Hello everyone, myself Dr. Manish Ashtankar. I'm a founder of Fumident, which works for quality control in healthcare. So today's topic is about accreditation in healthcare or in dental healthcare. This is going to be a very interesting topic because since many days, many people asking me that why do we need accreditations for our clinic or hospital, and that's why today we are coming with this video. So let's understand from a simple example. Suppose if you want to book any resort or hotel for a vacation, how do you select that hotel? आप जाके वहाँ पे पहले देखते नहीं हो कि कितना cleanliness maintained है, वहाँ के waiters कैसे behave कर रहे हैं, वहाँ का quality management system कैसा है, वहाँ का food कैसा है. Instead of that, we look for a star rating. If the hotel or resort is 5-star or 7-star or for that matter 3-star, we select that hotel or resort based on that star marking, and we understand that if that hotel or resort is 5-star, it means all quality management or all facilities that we want will be available there. Similarly, suppose any patient as a consumer wants treatment in a safe hospital, adequate quality control, there should be a standard of governance in that hospital. All the treatment should be covered in a medical ethical way. The staff in that hospital should be well qualified, educated, trained, and should follow all the standard protocols. There should be proper documented and implemented infection control policy, specifically in this corona time. The patient will be able to track his or her treatment record or medical record. And if patient wants to lodge a complaint against anything in that hospital, there should be some method or protocol to hear that patient and to solve his or her complaint. So how a patient will select any hospital or dental clinic based on all these criteria? And for that, the accreditation system works worldwide for a healthcare system. Let's see what is this accreditation. It is a self-assessment and external peer assessment process used by healthcare organizations to accurately assess their level of performance to implement these standards governed by these accreditation bodies and to implement ways to improve this standard regularly. So how did it start? So in early 20th century in USA, there was a concern for a good healthcare environment for clinicians. So they decide some standard based on which they implement those standard and they improve their organization. Later on, which convert into the accreditation body, and similar way, those accreditation bodies spreads worldwide. For example, JCI, that is Joint Commission International, which is a US-based accreditation system. In UK, there is a trained accreditation system. In Canada, there is an Accreditation Canada. And in Australia, there is an Australian Council on Healthcare Standard International. So is there any organization which provides such accreditations in India? So let's see. In India, if you want accreditation for hospital, dental care services, eye hospital, Panchakarma center or Ayush center, then there is a NABH accreditation which is governed by QCI, that is Quality Council of India. Similarly, there is an accreditation for a lab, that is NABL. For certification body, there is a NABCB accreditation. For education and training, there is a NABET, and for quality promotion, there is a NAQP. So all these accreditations are governed by Quality Council of India, which is an autonomous body by Government of India, established in 1997. They have set some standard for each and every organizations, and based on that standards, they do peer assessment, and after that they provide certification. So every country has such organizations which governs accreditations for healthcare, and these bodies get guided by some umbrella organization. For example, ISQUA, that is International Society for Quality in Healthcare. India is become a 12th nation which joined this ISQUA for accreditation. So the next most common question which was asked to me was, what are the benefits of this accreditation once it will get implemented? So this is the highest benchmark for any quality care or any healthcare in India. So the consumers which are properly educated, they will look for these accreditations nowadays in your city or in your state. So if you are accredited in your city or in your state, it will be more beneficial for you to attract such a crowd, as well as you can promote dental tourism, because patients from outside who looks for their dental treatment in India, for example, full mouth dental implants, they always look for such accreditations for your clinics. So if your clinic is NABH accredited, you can promote dental tourism. Again, if you want to get CGHS or ECHS empanelment, your clinic must be inspected by QCI. And if you are NABH accredited, you will get additional revenue benefit in CGHS scheme as well. So to conclude, this will increase commitment to quality care as well as patient safety. It will stimulate continuous improvement in your organization. Your patient, your staff, as well as you will be more safe in this environment. And this overall accreditation standards improve the confidence of community in your healthcare. So to conclude, what is the need of these standards or accreditation? So I must say, in today's corona time, as our patients get educated about cross infection, infection control, as well as these infectious disease, the quality is the need of present time. Because of that, there are a lot of improvement in the technology and availability of new equipment nowadays in dentistry. And because of that, dentistry is more and more effective but unsafe simultaneously. And that's why we should stick to some basic standards as well as get inspected by some peer assessment programs, so that we can continuously improve ourselves, and that will help to implement quality management system for our patient and overall healthcare system. Thank you.